request all the devotees, if it's possible, to sit closer, come closer, because the more concentrated we are, the more attentive we are. The more spaced out we are, the more spaced out we are. It's not a compulsion, it's just a request. If you feel inspired, otherwise if you want the backrest at the back, that's good. Whatever keeps your Hari Katha Shravan anukul, favorable, please accept that. Whatever is not rejected. So, is the voice audible for everyone at the back? Yes. You're at the back, Prabhuji?
Ganja Prabhu, can you hear?
So last night, on the auspicious occasion of Vaman Dwadashi, we very briefly discussed the pastime of the dwarf incarnation of Mahavishnu, Sri Krishna, where he appeared as Vamandev. And towards the end of the discussion, we made this point that Bali Maharaj, although he appeared in a demoniac family line, amongst the demons, he received one of the greatest gifts that a demon could aspire to get. First and foremost, he was not killed. Secondly, the Supreme Lord used him as an instrument to show the world the principle of surrender. Third, his pride was crushed. The pride that I have so much, and I possess so much, and I can give so much. This child cannot even ask properly. I can give much more than what the child is asking for. He's a foolish child who doesn't know what to ask and how much to ask. I can give much more. And the Supreme Lord took that right away. Gave eternal fame to Bali Maharaj. Even today, when sacred thread on the wrist is tied, they chant Danavendra Mahabali. When thread is offered, sacred thread, not around the body, but around the wrist, if someone donates anything, they say Danavendra Mahabali. So being a demon, he was not killed. Second, his pride was taken away. Third, he was given eternal fame. And fourth, the Supreme Lord placed his lotus feet on his head. And last night, we promised you that we would continue on that theme and speak about another person who shares the same good fortune. Someone who was a demon, who was not killed, who was given eternal fame, and the Lord placed his lotus feet on his head. For those who are thinking, yes, we are speaking about Kaliya.
Haribo.
So today, this morning, this evening, tomorrow morning, and tomorrow evening, we will speak about Krishna and Kaliya. In the 8th chapter of the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, it is described when Krishna was a child. He was very naughty. He would do things which children never do. Let's say most of them don't try to do. Krishna and Balaram were so naughty that Shringa Damushtra Ahi, it is described that Shringi, which means animals with big horns. It's a big animal with horn. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. That slips down, then like yesterday. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So the Bhagavatam describes Shringar Nidamshtra Ahijala Dvija Kanta Kebhya, that Krishna was so naughty as a child that he would go and touch the following. Shringi, which means he would go and touch the horns of very, very powerful bulls. He would go and touch the horns to see how sharp his horns were. He was that naughty. Mother Yashoda would say, just sit in one place and Krishna would go and you'd go and try to hold the horns of big, 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 really powerful bulls. Shringi. And Agni, wherever he would find fire, he would want to go and put his hand. Sometimes Krishna wants to enter fire also. And Balaram has to hold him and say, no, I want to see what it is. And sometimes, if not, at least let me try tasting it. Forget about tasting Krishna, you cannot even put your hand in there. Can't. That's Agni. First is Shringi. Second is Agni. Third, Damshtri. That Damshtri means Krishna put his hand into mouth of animals with sharp teeth. Like monkeys. They have really sharp teeth. And Krishna would cry, I want to put my hand into his mouth. I want to see how his mouth looks like. And then Ahi. He would go to touch snakes. If the Supreme Lord decides to be naughty, even sky is not the limit. So, Ahi means a snake. And Jala, he wants to go and swim in deep oceans when he doesn't even know to walk properly. And in some parallel readings of the Bhagavatam, instead of Ahi, the word used is Asi, which means a sword. So Krishna wants to go and touch swords to see how sharp they are, and he would want to touch it on his body. So every minute, every day, Mother Yashoda's heart used to just be jumping in anxiety. What is Krishna going to do today? So Shringi, touch the horns. Agni, touch fire. Damshtri, put his hand into the mouth of animals with teeth. Four, Ahi, touch snakes. Jala, jump into water and try to swim when he doesn't even know to swim. Dvija, he says, I want to go and look into the mouth of very, very big, dangerous birds. When vultures and eagles are around, Krishna will tell Mother Yashoda, I want to put my head into and see how their stomach looks like. And Kantakebhya, he wants to go and hold and walk barefoot on all the thorns. These were his daily activities. Bhagavatam describes, Shringagni Damshtra Ahijala Dvija Kantakebhya. So what were the different items? I'm having this repeated for a certain reason. Shringi, which means touching the
horns.
Agni.
Fire.
Damshtri.
Teeth.
Ahi.
Snakes.
Jala.
Water.
Dvija. Snakes. Birds. And Kantakebhya. Stones and sharp thorns. Want to touch and walk there. Shripad Hari Suriji, great commentator on the Srimad Bhagavatam, he writes, Krishna is making a foretelling of in the future what he is going to do. By touching the horns of the bulls, Krishna is showing the world that I am going to touch the horns of Arishnasuri. By touching Agni, Krishna is talking about swallowing the forest fire. Damshtri, by putting his hand into the mouth of animals, he's talking about Keshi. And Ahi Jala, snake in the water, Kaliya. And he also splits it by saying Ahi Jala, which means snake in the water, or Ahi Kaliya and Jala Govardha. Dvija, bird, Bakasura. And Kantakebhya, thorn-like unsaintly kings whom he is going to touch with his own hand and uproot from Mother Earth. Shripad Hari Suriji comments that by his baby pastimes, Krishna is showing the world what is coming up in the future. So much sweetness is there in the Srimad Bhagavatam that this Srimad Bhagavatam cannot be read or heard. It is to be drunk. Pibata Bhagavatam. And how much is the question? How much should we hear? How much should we drink the Srimad Bhagavatam? Because there's always dosage. You take this one cup, you take two cups, or whatever. How much Srimad Bhagavatam should we drink is the question. Unlimited, yes. But very beautifully it is described in the Bhagavatam. Pibata, drink. Bhagavata, rasamalayam. Alaya means storehouse. Like the storehouse of study, vidya, is vidyalaya. A school. The storehouse of books, library, is called granthalaya. Alaya means a storehouse or shelter. So rasam alaya, this storehouse of mellows or transcendental taste, pibata bhagavata rasam alaya. This is one meaning. Second meaning, Bhagavata refers to Bhagavan. So when Bhagavan performs rasa, which is Vrindavan, and Vrindavan is rasam alaya, the storehouse of rasa. So when Bhagavan is in Vrindavan, pibata, drink those pastimes. Third meaning, the word laya means to fall asleep. According to Madhurya Kadambini of Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he says the word laya refers to sleep. Laya, big shape, and so on and so forth. Viuda, vikalpa, and so on and so forth. Terms are used. So laya means to sleep. Alaya means to completely sleep, which means to go faint, or to die. So pibata bhagavata rasam alaya. Drink this nectar till the time you faint. till the time you're sitting on the chair, keep hearing. And once you faint and you fall, you cannot hear. But once you come back to consciousness and sit back on the chair, continue hearing. Alaya. The prefix a means too much. Like shrama means hard work. And when you have a prefix of ashrama, means that place where there's too much hard work. Brahmachari ashrama, grihastha ashrama, vanaprastha ashrama, sannyas ashrama. Shraya means to take shelter. A means too much. So ashraya means to take complete shelter. Similarly, laya means to sleep. Alaya means to completely sleep, which means to go unconscious. So pibata bhagavata rasam. Drink the nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam alaya till the time the body doesn't fall down. So Srimad Bhagavatam opens up beautifully with so much wonderful meanings. This is to be drunk. So Srimad Harisuriji says Krishna in the future is making a foretelling that I am going to enter water and kill and subdue this snake, Kaliya. And therefore he would touch snakes right from childhood. So because Kaliya had the same good fortune that Bali Maharaj had, being demoniac, he was not killed. His fame increased among all the demons. His pride was crushed and the Supreme Lord offered the signs and symbols of his lotus feet on his head by dancing on it. Since it is the same Vishaya, same topic. So from yesterday's topic of Bali Maharaj, we smoothly transition into our seminar discussion that is of Kaliya.
Vibho.
So I request as we start studying our Srimad Bhagavatam, if we either have copies of Srimad Bhagavatam or if you can pull it up on your phone, on Vedabase, or if there is a link that can be posted in a WhatsApp group or whatever is convenient. We are going to start discussing from Canto 10, Srimad Bhagavatam, Chapter 16 onwards. Chapter 16, text 1 onwards. Everybody ready? Please be attentive and very enthusiastic. The most auspicious, opportune moment has come in our life to hear Srimad Bhagavatam. Canto 10, chapter 16.
Everybody has?
I will continue only after everyone has it, because Otherwise, it's difficult to keep track of what is being discussed. Ready, everyone? Did you all pull up the verse? 10, 16, 1. Canto 10, chapter 16, text 1. Yes, Prabhuji is here. You have it? Okay. And Mataji is at the back. Do you have it?
Vedabase.com.
Yeah, maybe for now we will skip the TV.
Evening
show. Now we will just relish. We will just sit and let's drink together. And become drunkards in this assembly. Yes, so let's begin. Please chant. Shri Shukha Uvacha.
Shri Shukha Uvacha.
Vilokya Dushitam Krishna.
Vilokya Dushitam Krishna.
Krishna Krishna Hina Vibhu.
Krishna Krishna Hina Vibhu.
Tasya Vishuddhiman Vichyan.
Tasya Vishuddhiman Vichyan.
Sarvam Tannudavasayan. Please chant.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Vilokya Dushitam Krishna.
Vilokya Dushitam Krishna.
Krishna Krishna Hina Vibhu.
Krishna Krishna Hina Vibhu.
Tasya Vishuddhim Atvichyan.
Tasya Vishuddhim Atvichyan.
Sarvam Tam Udavasayat.
Matajis. Verses of Srimad Bhagavatam are Krishna themselves, so please don't shy. Even if we make mistakes, even if we don't know to read, struggling and crawling our way is better than standing in one place. Please.
Shri Shukha Uvacha. Krishna Krishna Hinavibhu.
Krishna Krishna
Hinavibhu.
Tasya
Vishuddhim Advichyan.
Translation. Do we have one more volunteer?
Sukadev Goswami said, Lord Shri Krishna, Supreme Personality of Godhead, seeing that Yamuna River had been contaminated by the black snake Kalia, desired to purify the river, and thus the Lord banished him.
So basically, Srila Shukadeva Goswami has summarized the whole pastime of Kaliya in one verse. One verse summarization of the whole pastime. Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, seeing that Yamuna River had been contaminated, why? Black snake Kaliya, he decided to purify the river and then banished him out. So the whole pastime is summarized in one verse. Now interestingly, Shukadeva Goswami, as he is speaking, look at the poetic play of words. In the same verse, three Krishnas are used. Vilokya, Dushitam Krishna, Krishna, Krishnahina, Vibhu. Did everyone see? And interestingly, all three different usages of Krishna refer to three different personalities. So the first Krishna refers to Yamuna. Because Krishna refers to Yamuna Rani. Yes, Krishna is the feminine usage. That is Yamuna Devi. The second is Krishna, masculine usage, the Supreme Lord. And the third, Krishna, which means an adjective used. The dark complexioned Ahi, the black snake, Kaliya. Is everyone able to appreciate this fact? This is Srimad Bhagavatam. Prati shloke prati akshare nana arthe kai. Krishna tulya bhagavat vibhu sarvashra. Every syllable of Srimad Bhagavatam is dancing Krishna. So now we will spend some time understanding the three Krishnas. We want to find one Krishna and we touch the Srimad Bhagavatam, and the first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam is ready to give us three Krishnas to pick from. So now Yamuna Rani is called Krishna because she flows in a dark complexion. In the confluence of the three holy rivers, Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati, Ganga flows in a white complexion, Yamuna flows in a black complexion, and Saraswati is invisible. She has unmanifested, so to speak, her pastimes. So Saraswati is invisible. So the mixing of Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati at the Triveni Sangam, the confluence of the three holy rivers, we see they don't mix together and form a common mixture. Ganga still continues to flow white and Yamuna continues to flow black. It is like the meeting of Radha and Krishna. It is like the meeting of Gaur Leela and Braja Leela. So therefore that Krishna, that dark complexioned river is described here, Yamuna. Yamuna Rani is very, very fortunate because Krishna's Sakya pastimes, friendship based pastimes take place on the banks of Yamuna. Krishna's Vatsalyamai pastimes with Balaram, where Balaram is showing love towards Krishna, takes place on the banks of Yamuna. Krishna's Madhurya pastimes with the Brajagopis takes place on the banks of the Yamuna. So Yamuna is very, very powerful and very fortunate. Sri Yamuna Rani, being the daughter of Sun God, she is called Bhanuputri. And Srila Rupa Goswami Pad very beautifully describes
Ramyatira Ramhamana Gokadamba Pushita Divya Ganda Bhakadamba Pushvaraji Roshita Nanda Sonu Bhakta Sangha Sangha Mabinandini Mampunatu Sarvada Aravinda Pandunandini.
Who is this Yamuna? Ramyatira, on her banks. Ramyatira, her banks are very, very attractive. Why? Because there, Ramhamana. Ramhamana means to make a sound like the cloud. That's Ramhamana. So Ramyatira, on the attractive banks of Yamuna, Ramhamana, go, which means cows. Kadamba means groups. Groups and groups of cows come there and decorate Kadamba Bhushita, the attractive banks of Yamuna. And they're all making their sounds on one bank. And on the other bank, Divya Gandha Bhak Kadamba Pushparaji Rushita. On the other side, the Kadamba flowers are very fragrant and there are forests and trees and canopies and groves on the other side. Divya Gandha with transcendental fragrance. Pushparaji Rushita. Oh, on one side are cows decorating like a necklace the banks of Yamuna, and on the other side of the Yamuna there are flowers of Kadamba, trees and groves and forests like canopies covering and decorating the upper banks. Now in the center is Yamuna. What is she doing? Nanda Sunu Bhakta Sangha Sangama Abhinandini. In the center is Yamuna and she's ecstatic welcoming groups and groups of devotees of the son of Nanda Maharaj. Nanda Sunu, the son of Nanda Maharaj, Bhakta Sangha, the groups of devotees, Sangama, they're meeting. Abhinandini, she's happy. And Rupa Goswami says, oh, that Yamuna who has cows on one side and flowers on the other and ecstasy in the center, Mam Punatu, may you purify me. Punatu, you see, Punatu comes very close to purity in English. Like the word puta in Sanskrit means purity. And the word na means no. So puta na means no purity. So punatu means purify. Mam punatu, oh Yamuna, please purify me. How much? Sarvada, all the time. And who are you? Rupa Goswami doesn't say Yamuna. He's a poet. So he says, Aravinda Bandhu Nandini. Oh, daughter of the sun god, who is the friend of the lotus? Why friend of the lotus? When the sun rises, the lotus opens. When the sun sets, the lotus closes. So they have a good friendship. And because Yamuna is the daughter of the sun god, Rupa Goswami could have said Bhanu Putri, Surya Putri, Aditya Putri, Aditya Nandini, Bhanu Nandini, and so on and so forth. But he doesn't say it like that. He says, Mam Punad Sarvada, may you purify me all the time, Aravinda, which means lotus, Bandhu, friend. Lotus friend is the sun. Aravinda, Bandhu, Nandini, daughter of the friend of the lotus. So very beautiful. When Yamuna got so much good fortune in Dwapar Yuga, Ganga Devi complained to Krishna. And she said, I was the one who washed your lotus feet. And you would sport with Radharani in Yamuna, but not in Ganga. You called me as Manasi Ganga at Govardhan, but there are more pastimes on Yamuna than Manasi Ganga. I need equal status. So Shri Krishna agreed. And he said, do not fear and do not worry. O Gange, in Kali Yuga when I come as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I will sport in the Ganga. Chaitanya Akhyam Prakatam Aduna Tad Dvayam Chaikyam Aptam Radha Bhava Dhuti Suvalitam Navni Krishna Saru. When Radha and Krishna are separate, they sport, or they sport in Yamuna in Vrindavan. But when they come together in one form as Gaurahari, Shachinandan Gaurahari, then the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sports in the Ganga. And even when he wants to sport in the Yamuna, he jumps into Ganga thinking it's Yamuna. And Srila Prabhupada writes in the purport, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, one very beautiful section. He says, when Ganga Devi is purified 100 times, then you get 1 drop of Yamuna. Srila Prabhupada has quoted, I can give you the reference. Srila Prabhupada says, when Ganga Devi is purified 100 times, then we get Yamuna. So that Krishna is described here, that Yamuna Rani. So first of all, the stage is described. Before the actor comes in, the stage must be ready. So even in his narration, he says Yamuna first. And just like we know, we always name Krishna with his energy, with his devotee. Yashoda Krishna, Radha Krishna, Sita Ram, Lakshmi Narayan, Lakshmi Narasimha. So before saying Krishna, he says Krishna Krishna. Like Kishore Kishori, Radha Raman. So like that, Krishna, Yamuna, Krishna, Krishna. Understand?
Vibho.
Now the second Krishna is described. Who is the second Krishna? Our Krishna. Our Brajendra Nandan Shyamasundar Shri Krishna. Now why is he called Krishna? Why is our Krishna called Krishna? What does the word Krishna mean? The one who is all attractive. Srila Prabhupada explains in Chaitanya Charitamrita, quoting from Mahabharata, even Jiva Goswami Pad quotes and explains the actual meaning of the word Krishna. Krishir bhuvachako shabdho nahcha nivritti vachakaha tayor aikyam parabrahma krishna iti abhidhiyate. What is the definition of the word Krishna? Mahabharata explains in Srila Prabhupada quotes that the word Krishna is made out of 2 syllables. Krish and Ana. Krishi bhu vachako shabdho. The syllable Krish refers to creation, maintenance and destruction. That Lord who is the creator, maintainer and destroyer of everything is Krish. The Lord of greatness is Krish. And Ana, na cha nivritti vachaka. The syllable na refers to removal of sorrow and giving of pleasure. So Krish means the Lord of greatness and na means the Lord of sweetness. And tayor aikyam parabrahma, when the Lord of greatness and the Lord of sweetness completely mix and intertwine themselves into one, Krishna iti abhidhiyate. Jiva Goswami Pad says, oh, that is Krishna. The Lord of greatness and the Lord of sweetness. Because if he is just sweet and he is not great, then he is a mere mortal. If he is just great but not sweet, oh, he is formal. But if he is great and sweet, oh, that is Krishna. Like Sri Narayana, He is great. But he deals with his devotees in a very formal way. He solves the problem of his devotees like a master. Like we saw yesterday in the Samudra Manthan pastime. How many times they went to Mahavishnu? And every time they would go to Mahavishnu, Mahavishnu would serve them like a master. There was no heart-to-heart connect. Aapko chahiye, main kar dunga, theek. I'm showing my mercy. Like, so he's the boss and we are the slave. Ara sabha vrittya. We are all servants. Yare yaiche na chayate taiche kare vrittya. Depending on how he makes us dance, we dance. So we are the servants and he is the Lord. That's Mahavishnu. But Sri Ram goes one step ahead. He doesn't solve the problems of his devotees like a master. He lets his devotees solve his problems. Interesting? Sri Ram lets his devotees solve his problems. He makes Hanuman solve his problems. He makes Guha solve his problems. He makes asuras like Vibhishan solve his problems. Imagine if your Guru Maharaj, who is well equipped with everything, he doesn't need anything, but he calls you up and says, I'm passing by Atlanta tomorrow. Can you make some breakfast for me? Can I pack it up in a lunchbox? If you do that for me, I will be very grateful. Now imagine, he could have chosen so many houses, but because he chose your house, your heart is melted for him. So when the Supreme Lord has his own lunchbox as Mahavishnu, it is formal. But Sri Ram makes a heart-to-heart connect by letting his devotee solve his problems. And Krishna goes one step ahead by solving the problems of his devotees by becoming their servant. So beautifully the Bhagavatam describes. Sārathya pārashata sevana sakhya dautya Veerasanamukamanastavana pranaman Svigdeshu pandushu jagat pranatincha vishnum Bhaktim karoti nripatish charanarvinde. How does the Supreme Lord Shri Krishna serve? Sarathya, by being the chariot driver. Parashada, by being the associate of the Pandavas. Sevana, by serving them. Sakhya, by being their friend. Dautya, by running around as a messenger. Veerasana, standing outside with a sword in his hand, guarding their tent at night. Anugamana, walking behind them. Do you want something? Can I get something for you? Veerasana Anugamana Stavana, by offering prayers to them. And Pranaman, by bowing down and giving obeisances. Svai Snigdeshu Pandushu, because he loves the Pandavas. And who is he? Snigdeshu Pandushu Jagat Pranatimcha Vishnu. The universe bows down to him as Vishnu and he bows down to his servants. Bhaktim Karoti Nripatish Charanarvinde. And when Parikshit Maharaj heard this, there was a burst of devotion in his heart. So beautiful. Srimad Bhagavatam, every verse is nectar. So this is Krishna, the Lord of greatness and the Lord of sweetness. In this world, the more famous somebody is, the more unapproachable he becomes. Yes. Assistants and servants and appointments and whatnot. So the greater we go, the more inaccessible he gets. So Krishna is the greatest, so he should just be completely inaccessible, but he's the most accessible Lord. So that Krishna. Shukadeva Goswami speaking about that Krishna. And Krishna and Yamuna are described back to back for sweetness. Srila Rupa Goswami Pad in the Padyavali, he gives a very beautiful verse. Please repeat. Govardhana Prastha.
Govardhana Prastha.
Navambhuvaha.
Navambhuvaha.
Kalinda Kanya.
Kalinda Kanya.
Navaneela Padmam.
Navaneela Padmam.
Vrindavanudara.
Vrindavanudara.
Ramala Shakhi.
Ramala Shakhi.
Tapastrayasya.
Tapastrayasya.
Abhibhavam Karotu.
Abhibhavam Karotu.
Thank you. You would feel like carrying this verse in your pocket everywhere. What does this mean? The devotee is telling Krishna, Krishna, How should I describe you? Govardhana Prastha Nava Ambuvah. Should I describe you as a freshly formed rain cloud hovering over Govardhana? Govardhana Prastha. Prastha means to be situated there. Because when Krishna would move over Govardhana, Nava Ambuvaha. Ambu means water, Vaha means to carry. So Ambuvaha is a cloud. And Nava means new. Should I call you as a new, fresh monsoon cloud hovering over, running around Govardhana? Or should I describe you as Kalinda Kanya Nava Neela Padma? Or should I describe you as a blue lotus swimming around the daughter of Kalinda? That is Kalindi. Or should I describe you as Vrindavana Udar Tamana Shakhi? Should I describe you as a big magnanimous tamal tree in the forest of Vrindavan? When I see you at Govardhana, I describe you as a freshly formed rain cloud over Govardhana. When I see you in the Yamuna, I describe you as the blue lotus flower. And when I see you in Vrindavan, I describe you as a magnanimously beautiful and powerful attractive tamal tree. The devotee then prays, Krishna, whether you are the new freshly formed rain cloud at Govardhana, or whether you are the blue lotus in Kalindi, or whether you are the tamal tree in the forest, may you in these forms destroy my Adidevi Klesha, Adi Bhauti Klesha, and Adhyatmi Klesha. Tapa Trayasya Abhibhavam Karo. May the three tapa, the distress caused by the mind, the distress caused by others, and the distress caused by natural calamity, be destroyed by these three poetic forms of yours. I told you, when you hear this verse, you'll feel like traveling, keeping this verse in your pocket and walking around. Whenever you are in a mall or whether you are amidst non-devotees and you feel your consciousness is coming down, Govardhana Prasthana Vambhuvaha, Govardhana Prasthana Vambhuvaha, Kalinda Kanya Navaneela Padmam,
Kalinda Kanya Navaneela Padmam,
Vrindavanodhara Tamana Shakhi,
Vrindavanodhara Tamana Shakhi,
Tapa Trayasya Abhibhavam Karotu,
Tapa Trayasya
Abhibhavam Karotu. So beautiful. So Krishna is always described as Yamuna, so poetic. Yamuna is there with Krishna right from Krishna's birth. She appears and touches Krishna's lotus feet. And she's there in Vrindavan pastimes. And later, when Krishna goes to Dwaraka, Yamuna leaves and comes as Kalindi, one of Krishna's eight principal queens in Dwaraka. So she's always there with Krishna. So this is the second Krishna. Now let's move to the third Krishna. See, this is one verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, 18,000 such verses. How much time do we have to waste in other activities? If we start discussing verse by verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, innumerable lifetimes we need. And therefore, acharyas say, I don't want moksha. Mama janmani janmani. I want to come back, but on the condition, may Srimad Bhagavatam be on my chest. This is Yad Vaishnavanam Priyam, which means Srimad Bhagavatam is very close to the heart of the Vaishnavas. Also meaning, if we want to be Vaishnavas, we have to become very dear to Srimad Bhagavatam. We have to go very deep in studying Srimad Bhagavatam. So the third Krishna is described. And who is that?
Kaliya.
So here Krishna means the dark complexion. Krishna also means dark complexion. When Krishna was being named by Gargacharya, Gargacharya was sent by Vasudeva Maharaj to name Krishna and Balaram. And Nanda Maharaj welcomed Gargacharya and said, how may I serve you? You have come all the way from Mathura. And I really desire if you can bless my two sons Krishna and Balaram. Gargacharya said, if I name and I bless your children, comes second, put the pieces together. Because I am the family priest of Vasudeva Maharaj. His son is going to be the cause of Kamsa's death. And here, Nanda Maharaj, the friend of Vasudeva, is being blessed by the family priest of Vasudeva Maharaj. Pieces come together as Krishna being the cause of Kamsa's death. So Nanda Maharaj said, don't worry, we will have it in the cowshed. Nobody, I'll not invite anyone. I won't even invite the Brajvasis. It's just going to be us. Most confidential knowledge. It's going to be Guhyatama. So at that time, interestingly, Krishna was seated on the lap of Rohini Devi. And Balaram was sitting in the lap of Mother Yashoda. Because the two brothers wanted, they nudged each other and they wanted to test how good Gargacharya is. Because if the baby is in the mother's lap, and if Gargacharya is not a good astrologer, he would say, oh, Rohini Nandan Krishna looks so beautiful. So to test Gargacharya and play with this devotee, they swapped over. And Gargacharya saw this. He saw Balaram sitting on Mother Yashoda's lap. And what did he say? I am he, Rohini Putra. Oh, this is Rohini Putra. What is he doing in Yashoda Rani's lap? And Balaram looks. He cut me. He says, I am he. I am means to point like this. I am in Sanskrit means to point. I am he, Rohini Putra. He means indeed, certainly, for sure. This is son of Rohini. What is he doing on Mother Yashoda's lap? Then the baby swap over. And then looking at Krishna, Gargacharya says, Shukla Rakta Tatha Pita Idanim Krishna Tangata. Shukla, this boy has appeared in different complexions. Shukla has white complexion, Vaman Devi yesterday. Rakta, red complexion, Varahadev, Rakta Varaha. Shukla Rakta Tatha Pita. Kali Yuga Pavana Kali Bhayanashana Shri Sachinandana Gao. Golden incarnation in Kali. So, Shukla, white complexion. Rakta, red complexion. Pita, yellow complexion. Idanim, but now, Krishnatam Gata. He has appeared in the dark complexion. So, he plays with the word. In the Acharya's comment, the Acharya's comment. He has come in so many different incarnations, but he was not so all attractive. But Idanim Krishnatam Gataha, now he has come all attractive. But at the same time, Krishna also means dull complexion. So he has come in different colors and attraction, but now he is dark Krishna and all attractive Krishna. Idanim Krishnatam Gataha. So beautiful. Balaram would always make fun of Krishna because of his complexion. He would say, in public, Mother Yashoda would send Balaram out to protect Krishna. She would tell Balaram, you should protect Krishna like the eyelid protects the eyeball. And Balaram would say, yes, yes, I will do it. Now can I go? Mother Yashoda would say, yes, one more instruction. Just make sure that Krishna doesn't go into the under the sun, he's already suntanned. And Balaram would say, okay, I'll take it. Any more instructions? Mother Yashoda would say, just make sure that he doesn't hide in caves, because he would get into the cave, but he would not know how to come out. And my baby would be stuck in some cave, and he's not even strong enough to shout, and I will lose my Krishna, so don't let him go inside caves. Balaram would say, okay. Mother Yashoda would say, oh, one more instruction. Just make sure that he doesn't go close to water bodies, because he knows to jump in, but he doesn't know to swim and get out. Balaram would say, all right, can I go now? Can I take him to the forest? Mother Yashoda would say, okay. Just one last instruction. Just make sure that he doesn't climb trees, because he slips and falls down and breaks his hands and legs. Balaram said, okay, I will make sure that I will protect him. Is that okay? Now can we go? Yeah, now you can. Just one last. Just make sure that Krishna doesn't eat those fruits in the trees, because sometimes poisonous snakes touch those fruits and Krishna would get poisoned and his body would turn bluish black. So don't let him do that. Every 1 hour keep feeding him something so that he doesn't look out for anything. Balaram would say, okay, anything else? No, I think now it's done. One last. Mother's heart, Mother Yashoda's heart bursts in affection. Trayacha Upanishad Bhicha Sankhya Yoga Ishta Satvatai Upagiya Manam Mahatmyam Harim Samanyata. Srila Shukadeva Goswami Pada in the 10th canto, 8th chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam, he says that Krishna, who is being described Traya by the three Vedas, Cha Upanishad Bhija by the Upanishads, and Samkhya Yoga Ischa Sattvatai, he is glorified by the yogic processes, he is glorified by analytical study, he is glorified by pure devotees as what? Upagiyamanam Mahatmyam. He is described repeatedly for his glories. That Hari, Samanyata Atmajam. Mother Yashoda was convinced that he is just a mere child belonging to her. So much love. So she would tell Balaram, yes, take care of Krishna. He said, now can I go? So many instructions you have given me. This is day one into the forest on Gopashtami. And Krishna would look up and say, thinking, good, I don't have instructions. And Krishna is trying to walk out. Mother Yashoda says, Krishna, now's your list. Turn back. Don't be a naughty boy. Turn back and listen to my instructions. Krishna is turning back. Mother Yashoda says, you have only one instruction. Hold on to your Balaram, your brother's hand tightly. You're not going to run and follow Karam, okay? Be a good boy. In the absence of the father, the older brother is the father. So listen to him. So they go into the forest. Then when Krishna gets cranky after many days, he comes and tells Mother Yashoda, this island that you sent with me to protect me, I need an island from this island. There's no difference. He makes more fun of me in front of my friends than all my friends put together. Mother Yashoda, I have a request. Krishna says when he's 2 years old. When am I going to get married? Just get me married off, quick. No more waiting. Krishna, why do you want to get married? Oh, there's a big story for it. How do I don't know where to start. You know, Balaram? In public, in front of all my friends, he asked me. Krishna, Mother Yashoda is fair. Nanda Maharaj is fair. Why are you dark? And Krishna looks at his brother. Vedaham samati tani vartamanani charjuna bhutani cha bhavishyani mam tu vedana kashchana. Krishna says, I know everything past, present and future of all living beings at all times, but no one knows me. He didn't have an answer. Looked at Balaram and he's choking up and drops of tears. Acharya has described, it was almost like necklaces falling from Krishna's eyes because each drop of his tear was like a bow. And one tear was connected to another, 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 was connected to another. So a pearl necklace was falling from both his eyes. Yadi Acharya na hoi to tabe ki ho. If not for our Acharyas, what would we have done? How would Srimad Bhagavatam open up? What would we know? By reading, what can we understand? This is one of the greatest gifts Srila Prabhupada gave the world. Srimad Bhagavatam. He carried Shukadeva Goswami's words. He carried the current of the Acharyas. He gave his own explanations, crushing it down like baby powder so all of us can understand. So we must take shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam. So back to Mother Yashoda. So Krishna's looking, Balaram. Balaram said, yeah, I'm waiting. Do you have an answer, Krishna? Why are you dark? All the friends are laughing. It's like walking around. Krishna said, you. And Krishna is looking. He's being cornered. He looks at Balaram. Balaram says, I know the truth. But your heart would break. I never told you this. you are not the Achyut. You are actually not the son of Mother Yashoda. Na khalu Gopika Anandan. You are not the son of Mother Yashoda. You are not the son of Nanda Manohar. It's truth because Krishna is Ajanma. Ajopi san avyayatma bhutanam ishwaropi san prakritim swam adhishthaya sambhavami atmamayaya. So acha api, Krishna is unborn, so how can he have parents? What Balaram is saying is correct. But in Leela Spurti, in Leela Rasa, he is saying, you are not the son of Nanda and Yashoda. Somebody dropped you off in a marketplace, Krishna. Nanda and Yashoda picked you up from there because they felt pity. How could they leave you there? And Krishna starts crying and crying and crying. He comes to Mother Yashoda and embraces. Is it true that I am not your son? I would proudly go around saying that I am Yashoda Nanda. Is it true that I have no one in this world? Mother Yashoda said, what nonsense are you talking? You are my son. Now in the Shastra it is described Krishna as Devaki Nanda. Jayati Janani Vaso, Devaki Janma Vado. Krishna is Devaki Janma. Now is Krishna the son of Devaki or Yashoda? Our acharyas give a very beautiful purport. Srila Chakravarti Pad gives a beautiful purport. He says, Dve Namni Nanda Bharyaya Yashoda Devaki Dija. That Mother Yashoda had another name called Devaki. So apart from Devaki Rani in Mathura, Mother Yashoda also had one more name called Devaki. So every time Krishna is called the son of Devaki, it is the second name usage of Yashoda Rani. Dvi Namni Nanda Bharyaya. The Bharya of Nanda Maharaj, the wife of Nanda Maharaj had two names, Yashoda Devaki Picha. Chakravarti Pad comments. So this Krishna, he tells Mother Yashoda, enough mother! How long will I be mocked upon like this for my complexion? Just get me married off to a very beautiful girl. Then I can go and tell Balaram, so what if I'm dark complexion? I at least have a beautiful girl, you don't. So Mother Yashoda is relishing. Krishna's 2 years old. She says, acha, okay, very good proposal, very good solution. And now do you also have girls in mind? Now Krishna makes a very serious face and he tells Mother Yashoda, Maya, in Braja there is a custom. It's not that the boy and the girl get married, two families get married to each other in Braja, in Vrindavan. Two families must get married to each other. And Mother Yashoda is like, yeah, true. And therefore, oh mother, it must be someone who's very close to your heart and very close to Nanda Maharaj's heart. And I have seen this, that Vrishabhanu Maharaj is very close to Nanda Maharaj. And I have seen Mother Kirtita is very close to you. And therefore, because families have to be married together, I feel Vrishabhanu Nandini Srimati Radharani is a very good option. And then Mother Yashoda says, okay, any more reasons why you want to get married? Krishna says, look mother, my name is already very spoiled in Vrindavan. People think I'm a liar, I'm a cheat, I'm a stealer, I barge into other properties and pots and butter and all of that. Who would want to get their daughter married off to such a stealer? I am Hari. Now as I age, this reputation, ill reputation will spread far and wide. Now it's not so much. So just get me married off quickly. Then I'll continue stealing so she cannot leave me. So in this way, Mother Yashoda has very beautiful, heart-wrenching pastimes with Krishna. Very, very beautiful. She would dress up Krishna so beautifully, attractive with chandan and kumkum and aguru and temple and musk and all of that. And Krishna would go out and take all of that out and take the dust of Vrindavan and mix it up with cow dung and cow urine and pat it all over his face and body. And Mother Yashoda would say when he comes back, what is this, like a pig you are? You're playing in the sewage like a pig. What is this, Krishna? Pankhavi shikta sakalava yagam vilokya damodaram vadati kopavashat yashoda tvam sukaroshi gata janmani putanare. Oh, killer of putana, were you a pig in your previous life? And Krishna thinks, she's right, I was varahade.
Dashavatar. So what my mother is saying is right. Iti uktasa smita mukho vatuno murari. Hearing this, Murari smiled. So that complexion, Krishna, megha shyam, nava jaladhara shyam, shyam sundar. He's dark, but he's very beautiful. He's black beauty, he's dark beauty. So that, Krishna. Vilokya dushitam krishnam krishna krishna ahina vibhu tasya vishuddhiman vichan sarpam tam mudavasam. So, one more meaning of Krishna is that now here all three are dark. Yamuna is dark, Kaliya is dark, and Krishna is dark. So, one Acharya comments, so naturally Krishna is favoring the like-minded. Naturally, Krishna wants to favor the like-minded. So Yamuna is dark, so Krishna wants to purify her. And Kaliya is dark, so Krishna wants to purify her. Krishna wants... So it's natural that Krishna will be equally disposed to Krishna and Krishna Ahina. So this is called as Kakakshi Nyaya. You see a crow, at a time you can see only one eyeball. Only one eyeball. You'll either see like this or like this or like this or like this. You cannot see both eyes of a crow. You'll see only one eye at a time. So when one word, so it's believed that he has only, it's poetically believed he has only one eyeball which moves through two sockets. Right? So when one word is used for both contexts, it's called Kakakshinya. So here, interestingly, the first word is Krishna, Yamuna. The third word is Krishna, which is the black serpent, and in the center is Krishna, our Krishna. So that one eyeball of Krishna is moving through the two eye sockets for Yamuna and Kaliya equally. Understand? So he desired to purify both of them. And saying this, Parikshit, Shukadeva Goswami decides to move ahead and speak another pastime. But Parikshit Maharaj is a very attentive listener. If Shukadeva Goswami goes to the other topic, before he moves ahead, Parikshit Maharaj stops and he says, "Now wait a minute, you summarize the whole pastime in one verse. Who, which serpent, where does he come from, who is he, how did he get into Yamuna, and how did the dark complexion Lord purify him? I want to hear this in Shrotum Ichhamyaham Prabhu. I want to hear this in great detail." So text 2, please open up, 10.16.2. Parikshit Maharaj is digging the pastime further and he wants to know what is happening. He wants to know what is happening. So, a kind footnote here. Since this pastime runs through two chapters, it is not practical for us to cover all the verses. Unless I either move to Atlanta or you move to Minnesota, either way, then we can discuss Kaliya Daman in great detail. But I am just taking some verses out so that we chew the Sanskrit and try understanding the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam. The seminar topic is glories of Srimad Bhagavatam. But I don't just want to speak on the glories of the Srimad Bhagavatam. It's like just describing the sweetness of a mango. The best way to describe the sweetness of a mango is to provide the mango and now you start sucking it yourself. Right? So to take a section of the Srimad Bhagavatam and relish is the actual glorification of the Srimad Bhagavatam, than to just speak four sessions on the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam. Yes? Text 2.
Shri Rajo Vacha
Katham Antar Jale Gaadhe Nyagriha Bhagavanahim Savai Bahu Yugavasam Yatha Sid Viprakathyata
Shri Rajo Vacha
Some volunteer for the translation, please. Yes, Gopal.
In Parashat Inquiry, the Lord says, please explain how Supreme Personality of Godhead chastised Supreme Kaliya within the unfathomable waters of the universe.
basically Parikshit Maharaj is digging through what is happening. Katham, he says, how? Antar jale, jala means water, antar means inside. Katham antar jale, agade, unfathomable, inconceivable. Sometimes people, the great sages are called agada bodha. Bodha means intelligence or understanding, and agada, inconceivable understanding, unfathomable, completely inexplicable. So agade, katham antarjale, how come inside the water of the Yamuna, agade, in an inconceivable way, Bhagavan ahim nya grinath, Bhagavan, the Supreme Lord, how did he subdue this snake? And sir, that snake, bahu yuga vasam. Vasa means to reside, and yuga means ages. And bahu yuga, many ages. So how did that snake live for many, many ages there? Yatha asit vipra o brahmana kathyatam. Please explain to me how, first of all, he lived underwater, and how did the Supreme Lord chastise him? And third, how did he live there for so many years? So three questions I'm asking. To this, Sripad Sanatana Goswami comments in his commentary, and he says that Kaliya had a siddhi called Jalasthamba Siddhi. Jalasthamba Siddhi means to make solid structure underwater. Jala means water and sthamba means a pillar. Sthambe Savaya Angam Ridam Namarusha. Just like Narasimhadev came, half man, half lion, from a sthamba. Sthamba also means to be in shock. Like Gira just described as sthamba avatar of the Lord. He's stunned. Therefore, the rocks of Gira don't move. So, Jala Sthamba. Kaliya had the mystic potency of making solid structures underwater. And that's how he lived. Now, how the Lord chastised him and how come he lived there for such a long time, that Shukadeva Goswami will start describing. But Parikshit Maharaj has one more very beautiful verse to chant. Text 3. Brahman Bhagavatastasya Bhumna Shvachanda Vartinaha Gopaludara Charitam Kastripyetamritam Jushan. Translation.
O Brahmana, the unlimited Supreme Personality of Godhead freely acts according to his own desires. Who could be satiated when hearing the nectar of the magnanimous pastimes he performed as a cowherd boy in Vrindavan?
Very beautiful. Brahman, O Brahmana, Bhagavatastasya Bhumna Swachandavartinaha. Chanda means desire, and Swachanda, by his own desires, he moves around. Janmadhyasya yatonvayati taratas charteshu abhinya swarat. He's completely independent. Completely independent. So is it true that the Lord is completely independent? How many say yes, how many say no?
No.
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 Aham bhakta
paradhino. Aham bhakta paradhino yah swatantra ivodvijaha sadhu bir krasta ridayam bhaktair. Now in astrology, when you see somebody's chart, and if you say that, oh, planetary positions are really bad and they are acting on that individual, we say that person is graha grasta. Graha grasta. Graha means planet, and grasta means captured. He's captured by the planet, by the ill effects of that planet. Graha grasta. What is Krishna saying? Sadhu vir grasta ridayam. The sadhus have caught my heart. This is the Srimad Bhagavatam. Krishna is not saying I am controlled by my sadhus. No, he is saying sadhu vi grasta ridayam. Oh, just like the planets catch hold and control the person, the sadhus, they move my heart. And therefore, aham bhakta paradhin. That independent Lord is completely dependent on his pure devotees. Namamishwaram sache ananda rupam lasatrunayam bhumle vrajamanam. Bolo. Namamishwaram sache dependent. He is running in fear and crying. Rudantam mohur netram yukma rajantam karamboja yukumena satanka netram. Two yuga. Yugala means two. So with his two hands, he is rubbing his two eyes. So he was not one hand and one eye, or one eye and one hand and both eyes, or two hands and one eye. Rudantam muhuhu. Again and again he is crying. Yukmam rajantam karamboja yukmena satanka netram. How beautiful. Acharya's comment, Krishna really got scared that day. I don't want to go from Kaliyadaman to Dhampadar Leela. We'll leave that for the next month.
Kartik
month. By some other Vaishnava.
No.
But the point is, Krishna is completely dependent. So, Bhumna Swachanda Vartinaha. Krishna is completely free. And Gopala Udara Charitam. Now this is a very beautiful line. Please, this is the second line you have to carry in your pocket. Gopala Udara Charitam. This pastime that is coming up is Udara Charitam. Udara means magnanimous. Udara. Gopala Udara Charitam. Now how this is Udara Charitam, for that you have to stay with us for more sessions. So I'm not going to describe that now. But this is another term to carry in our heart. The word Gopala. What does it mean? He who protects the
house.
He who protects the
senses.
He who protects the
Goswamis.
He who protects the
land.
Govardhan. He who protects the planet of Go Loka. He who protects the family of Go Kula. And the waves of Yamuna are also called Go. So by Kaliya Damani, he who protected the waves of Yamuna is Gopala Udara Charitam. He gave his magnanimous mercy by protecting the waves. Go also means the waves. Because here the context could be, why is Parikshit Maharaj saying Gopal when there is no cow here? So the usage here is that through his Udara Charitam, through his magnanimous pastime, he is protecting the waves of Yamuna, and by hearing that, he is protecting the senses of the listener. So beautiful. So beautiful. Brahman Krishna Katha Punya Madhvilo Kamalapaha Konu Trippyeta Shrumvana Shrutatnya Nityanutana. When the Brahmanas came into the assembly of Queen Kunti, Queen Rukmini, in the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter 50-51, and so on and so forth, they are describing to each other, Brahman, Krishna Katha, Punya. Same point that Parikshit Maharaj is making here. Kastripyetamritam jushan. Who can say enough to Krishna Katha? Krishna Katha is very interesting. Don't ever get close to Krishna Katha. It will destroy your life. It will destroy your material plans. It will even destroy your spiritual life. Why? Because the anxiety to hear increases even more. And now when you don't get it, you're like a fish out of water. Hari katha kothai, kothai, kothai. You're running around. Where is it? Where is it? Bandhu sange jadi tava ranga parihas. Srila Bhaktivinoda, very beautifully he says, if we want to enjoy in this world, make sure that we never go on the banks of Keshi Ghat and look at the beautiful moonlight face of Govinda. Because if we look at the beautiful moon-like face of Shri Krishna, oh, he will take everything away. Dhanam cha manam cha yatendriyani pranam cha ritva mama sarvameva. Krishna steals everything away. Gopal. So hearing about him, Parikshit Maharaj is saying, kastri pitamritam mahat. Or Jushan. That who is that person who will not listen to Krishna Katha, or listening to Krishna Katha says enough. Or says, no, I'm satisfied. No. We were unsatisfied before, so we started hearing. Now the taste has increased so much that if we stop, he said, no, continue. Ani aur. We want more. So, kon trippyeta shrunvana. That parallel verse in Rukmini Rani's kingdom. It said, kon trippyeta shrunvana. Who is that listener who will be satisfied? No one. Same point is mentioned, Canto 10, chapter 1, text 4. Nivritta tarshaye upagiyamana bhavaushada shrotra manobhirama ka uttama shloka gunanubhadat puman virajeta vina pashugna. The person who says enough, yeah, I have heard enough of Krishna Katha. Parikshit Maharaj says he's a butcher. So he knows only to cut down. Krishna Katha is nitya. Satatam kirtayanto maam. Satatam doesn't mean once a year. Satatam means non-stop. Kirtaniya sada hari, non-stop. Nityam bhagavata sevaya, non-stop. So our true test of spiritual life is in the taste that we have in chanting the holy name and hearing Krishna Katha and serving the Vaishnavas. These are the three parameters to check how much advancement we are making. If we are enjoying chanting our japa, if we are relishing hearing Krishna Katha and we forget everything else and just feel like sitting here, and we serve Vaishnavas who are hearing Krishna Katha and chanting the holy name selflessly, we want to do, oh, they are hearing Krishna Katha and chanting the holy name, let them continue, I want to facilitate everything for them. Oh, these are parameters for making advancement, or that we have made advancement. So, in this pastime, Gopala Udara Charitam, hear and remember this phrase in your pocket and in your mind as we are discussing this will be unfolded. So, Udaracharitam, Gopala Udaracharitam. One quality of Sri Krishna, the word Udara means magnanimity. One quality of Krishna is that he never rejects anyone who comes to him. When Uttana caught hold of Krishna and Krishna was sucking her life air out, Sa Munchar Munchar Alam Iti Prabhashini. Shukadev Goswami says Parikshit Maharaj, Putana was yelling and screaming on top of her lungs, Krishna, enough, leave me, let me go, Muncha, Muncha, Alam, enough, enough, enough. Just leave me, let me go. Srikad Hari Suriji comments there and he says, she's telling the wrong person to leave. Krishna only knows to hold, he doesn't know to leave and let go. Whoever comes to him, Krishna only knows to accept them. He doesn't know to reject them. So if she is telling Krishna, leave me, he's never going to leave her. So much so that Putana starts flying in the air and Krishna still latched onto her. Srimad Hari Suriji writes, if Krishna would have left Putana there, the bird community would have cried that you hold on to only people on the ground, and as soon as you come on the air and you hold on to someone in the air, you let go. But to give faith even to those who are flying in the air, Krishna didn't let go of Putana even there at that point. So that the bird species, Khaga, they can feel whether on the ground or in the air, if Krishna holds, he never lets go. In one of the yatras of Srila Radhanath Swami Maharaj, Pejavar Swami of the Udupi Mutt spoke a very beautiful point. His grace Radha Gopinath Prabhu was translating from Kannada. And Pejavar Swami said a very beautiful point about Sri Krishna, Gopala Udara Charitam. He said, Krishna works against gravity. So no one understood. He said, the nature of gravity is that when anything is thrown up in the air, gravity pulls it down. And the nature of Krishna is that as soon as the consciousness falls, he uploads. Udara Charitam. He never rejects anyone. Yat gatva na nivartante. In the Gita he says, once we approach Krishna, we never again fall back. Which means even demons, when they come from Mathura, Agasur, Bakasur, Venukasur, Putana, Trinavarta. They come from their home and come to Krishna. Once they come, they never return. Yad gatva na nivartante. Tad dhamam paramam. Uttarachati. So in this way, Krishna is very, very merciful. Shukadev Goswami starts speaking the next verse, describing the actual scene of the pastime of Kaliya. But this we will continue in the evening session. We will start with text 4 in the evening session. This was the introductory warm-up as the Katha builds up. Parikshit Maharaj has spoken. Now Sri Shukha Uvacha, which will begin from text 4, where he starts describing Kaliya and his lake in the Yamuna. We will have that in the evening at what time? 6 o'clock. So 6 o'clock Katha will begin. So please be on time.
6 to 8:30
in the evening. So 6 hours from now, we have Katha. We will continue from text 4 and we will see what Krishna and Kaliya and how they interact. Granthra Srimad Bhagavatam Ki
Jai.
Srila Prabhupada Ki
Jai.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.